Hello, I'm Naomi Eberle. I had the pleasure to collaborate with Snap on the Responsive Plants template, using new physics features available in Lens Studio 4.31. What are they? Plants that respond to physical forces. What are they like?
Sort of flexible.
They dance gracefully in the wind.
Sometimes they move when you bump into them, as if to say, "Ah, you again."
So how do we make it happen in Lens Studio?
Flexible physics bodies made up of a chain of rigid segments that drive a 3D armature, which in turn deforms a plant model, and sometimes some extra rigging behind the scenes to hold it all up. In this tutorial, we'll first explore how some of the plants in the Responsive Plants template work. Next, we'll practice implementing new ones using the generator scripts provided within. So let's get going.
Seaweed is basically the essential responsive plant. It's all plant, and there's no extra rigging behind the scenes. A physics world with slight upward gravity simulates the force of the water pushing up on the plant. So the seaweed just kind of hangs up off the ground. Each flexible frond is made up of several rigid segments. Each segment is a tangible, dynamic physics body. Tangible, so other objects can bump into them, and dynamic, so that each segment can float around on its own, as long as it hangs on to its neighbors. Constraints are the fibers that hold the ends of the segments together. The base segment has a fixed constraint targeting the ground, so that it stays rooted down. The rest of the segments are each constrained to the one before them, using a hinge so that they can fold at the seams. So, how about a stem?
Watch out. Things are about to get tense.
A tension stem is a great way to help plants stand up to gravity. Good job, buddy. The tension stem has basically the same setup as the seaweed frond. Physics body segments strung up with constraints.
But
this time, they get a little help from the tension rod. It's like an invisible stick that goes from the base to the tip of the stem, and the tip is pinned onto it so it stays up. And of course, a flower head pinned to the top as well. We'll practice pinning flower heads in a later section of this video. The tension rod is just one type of extra rigging. Next up, suspension. This fern is made of 14 suspension fronds, similar to seaweed fronds. Each frond is rooted to the pot and spreads out horizontally from the center point. The center tether is an invisible spire that sticks right up out of the center of the pot. Fixed to the center tether are cranes sticking out above each frond. Each segment of the frond is constrained to both attachment points, kind of like with invisible string. So, hopefully you're starting to get a sense of how responsive plants are set up. Remember, each plant structure is made of segments and constraints, with some extra rigging, whatever's needed to hold them up. Next up, we're going to practice implementing a new suspension frond using the suspension frond generator script provided in the template.
We'll need to import a rigged 3D model of the new frond. The frond should be modeled and rigged as an arch. You want this to be the base shape that the frond returns to when no forces are acting on it. Default rigging settings should do the trick. As long as you have bones or joints set up to deform your model, you should be good to go. In Lens Studio, first, let's create a flower pot. Every suspension frond needs to attach to a center tether, and the flower pot has one built in. Reposition the flower pot and change its scale so that we can see it a little bit better in the preview. We'll hide the extra rigging. The center tether and counterweights will still be there in the background. We just won't see them on the preview.
Drag the plant model into the Resources panel. The default import settings should work for us. Now let's add a frond to our scene. Open up the folder and drag the model itself into the Objects panel. We'll resize and reposition this as well, so it fits in the pot.
Select the main frond object and add a script component. Apply the suspension frond generator script to the script component. We just need to tell the script which bones to use. In the frond joints array, Add values until you have enough slots for all of the bones in your rig. Make sure to include the end joint in that calculation. Once you have enough slots, just drag each bone into the slots until they're all filled. Make sure to do that in order.
Next, we should specify attachment points to help the frond stay upright.
For the base anchor, we'll use the pot object. Technically, we're using its physics body. Drag the center tether object into the center tether slot on the script component as well. Again, this one uses the physics body automatically. If you want, you can use a specific matter resource, which will be applied to all the segments in this chain. Finally, we'll need to set new values for the base and tip collider laterals. This is the width and height of the boxes that will be used as segments for this frond. The values on the left are width, and the values on the right are the height. If we set all the values to 10 and show colliders, collider boxes will now show up in the preview. The right size depends on the size and shape of your frond. If you move the frond around and change its angle, you can watch in the preview window how that affects the size and shape of its segments. Sometimes it takes a few tries to get the right size, so don't get discouraged. Once the segments are looking the right size, we can hide them. It's time to duplicate this frond. Remember, they all have to stick outward from the center tether. It can be helpful to look at the pot from directly above. Once you have all the duplicates built, reset the preview and they should all fall into place.
Next, we're going to make a new tension stem flower by replacing the head on one of the ones in the template. We'll be using an existing stem so we can model the flower head on its own. No bones needed this time, but make sure it's sitting on the origin point before exporting. In Lens Studio, turn on the scripted collision rig generators example. We just need one flower, so we can delete the rest of the plants. I'm going to hide the fan and backdrop as well. Hide the existing flower head collider. You can delete it if you want, but I'm going to keep it here as a placeholder for an upcoming step. Now let's import the new flower head. Drag the file from a file browser window to the resources panel in Lens Studio. We can use default import options. Drag the new flower head into the tension stem generator object. If you kept the old flower head, they should be in the same group. We won't need the old flower head anymore, so I'll delete it. Position the new flower head on top of the stem. It doesn't have to be exact yet. Depending on how you set up and export the model, the mesh object might come inside an outer group. In some cases, keeping the group might enable more complex animations or physics setups. In our case, it will be simpler to just have the one mesh object. Add a physics body component to the flower head mesh object. Now let's make the physics body match the shape of the flower. Select the shape type on the physics body component and change it to mesh. We'll use the same mesh resource that's used to visually render the flower. Drag the mesh resource from your imported model's meshes folder into the mesh field on the physics body component. Now the physics body mesh matches perfectly with our render mesh visual. This mesh is almost ready to use in physics calculations. Finally, check the convex box on the physics body component. Lens Studio generates a mesh that is fully optimized for physics simulation. The convex mesh forms a cage right around the outer edges of your main mesh. Now let's pin this flower head to the tension stem. Select Tension Stem Generator A. Drag the new flower head collider object into the flower head collider field on the script component. The head should now remain attached to the stem. Let's look at some common settings that help optimize the flower's behavior. In the Tension Stem Generator's Advanced Setup section, turning up damping and angular damping can help smooth out unexpected motions in case the stem twitches. Most of the settings affecting the flower head apply to the flower head object itself. Let's select it. It can be helpful to start with a low density value for the flower head. The flower head also has its own damping and angular damping settings. Position the flower head slightly above the tip of the stem, so it has a little bit of room to settle.
We can also add a physics matter resource to affect the friction of the flower head. Create a physics matter resource and drag it onto the proper slot on the flower head physics body component. I'll just move the fan a little bit higher so the main beam affects the flower head. And that should do it!
Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoy playing and creating with responsive plants. Don't forget to subscribe to SnapAR for more Lens Studio tutorials. This is only the beginning. There are so many different types of plants out there that behave in wild ways. I hope this inspires you to become the engineer of the next crop. Take care.